You can read the tea leaves. So the DA has announced, basically she's indicting Donald Trump, and security needs to get ready. She's going to announce these indictments coming in the summer. And I'm going to give you the background. You will come to the same conclusion that I have. She's only talking about primarily indicting Donald Trump. So let's put it up full mass here, give you some significant update. Fulton County DA, Fani Willis, Fulton County, Georgia, on Monday, says she would announce this summer whether former President Donald Trump and his allies will be charged with crimes related to the alleged interference in Georgia's 2020 election. So DA Willis revealed the timetable in a letter to who? Not to the public, not on Twitter, and not via a press release, but directly to the sheriff of Fulton County. His name is Patrick Labatt. So the DA sends a letter to the sheriff, okay, in which she is requesting that they be ready for a heightened security and preparedness, because she predicted her announcement may provoke a significant public reaction. In the letters, Willis said she will announce possible criminal indictments between July 11th and September 1st, sending one of the strongest signals yet that she is on the verge of trying to obtain an indictment against Trump and his supporters. Now, I'm going to provide some inside politics on this, okay? DA Fani Willis and Sheriff Patrick Labatt, they have a great working relationship. The DA could have easily called the sheriff and said, hey, sheriff, between these dates, I need to make sure we have heightened security. And the sheriff would oblige because he cares about his job. Well, she decided to write a letter. This letter got exposed, okay? The letter lays out the security protocol that now we have access to. The letter. There's more. Please accept this correspondence as notice to allow you sufficient time to prepare the sheriff's office and coordinate with local, state, and federal agencies to ensure that our law enforcement community is ready to protect the public, Willis wrote to Fulton Sheriff Patrick Labatt. We also have the chief of police involved. So let's put up their pictures. So you have Patrick Labatt, and Labatt is sheriff of Fulton County. A similar letter was handed also to Darren Sharbaum. He is the chief of police for the city of Atlanta. And Matthew Kallmeyer, director of the Atlanta Fulton County Emergency Management Agency. Several legal observers closely following the Fulton County investigation, which Willis launched more than 2 years ago, said the letters do in fact suggest that DA Fani Willis is absolutely seeking charges against the former president, former Gwinnett County District Attorney Danny Porter, okay? Longtime DA Danny Porter. So Danny Porter said, it obviously seems to imply the case against Trump will be presented to a grand jury. Former Gwinnett County DA Danny Porter said, I don't think any of the other targets would raise that level of caution. I think that's the obvious implication. Keep his picture up because I want to explain why his opinion is so relevant. Number one, he's been an elected DA of a major county. That major county is located right next door to Fulton County. Fulton County is next door to Gwinnett County. He is giving you the inside of what's happening. Why? Because many of the prosecutors who used to work for him work now in Fulton County. Do you not think at least one prosecutor has told him what the real deal is going to be? That's why his opinion about the matter on record is so important. Also, Norm Eason, former ethics czar, let's put him up. He's the former ethics czar under President Barack Obama, who co-authored a Brookings Institute report on the Fulton probe. Guess what? He agreed completely with the former district attorney of Gwinnett County that charges, an indictment, will be announced against Donald Trump. While she does not have the former president's name in her letter, he says, The evidence and the applicable law in Georgia point to the substantial likelihood that Donald Trump and his principal co-conspirators will be included when she follows through on the plans, she confirms in this letter, according to the former ethics czar. Now, another bit of irony. I know we keep focusing on the infamous phone call that Donald Trump made, who, by the way, he said it was perfect, a perfect phone call. That perfect phone call may not be as pivotal in the prosecution of Donald Trump. Remember, there's something else a little more, let's just say, heavy as evidence is concerned in a court of law. It's called a signature. You see, Donald Trump and his cronies also engaged in another operation where they had fake electors say they were real electors, sign an affidavit, sworn affidavit saying they were the real electors and you should count their ballots. And then they mailed that affidavit to D.C., hoping that the people in D.C., Mike Pence in particular, would be down with the program, right? They signed it against the law, under penalty of perjury, a sworn affidavit, under the direction and coordination of the Trump campaign and maybe even Trump himself as another strategy. That is part of this investigation also. And it is probably the only part of the investigation that is on face value completely illegal. You signed an affidavit swearing and affirming and attesting to these facts that were not facts at all. And you knew it. All right. Sharon, you know Fani Willis, you've interviewed her, and you have a sense of her personality as well. What do you think?
I think she's built for this. I think she's playing chess, and I think she knows what to say, when to say it, what not to say, including to perhaps her children, okay? Mm-hmm. Exactly what she wants to get out will get out. And I got to tell you, when she ran for judge, right, Dr. Richey, and did not get that bid, that's a good thing. Because this is perfect for her. She will see it through. And this pint-sized petite woman has something planned for all of these people who dared walk into a courtroom and think that they, well, they were playing checkers, Dr. Richey.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. I mean, she has them dead to the wrong in so many ways, and they messed around and did it in the wrong jurisdiction. That's what happened. All right, we'll give you updates as they come.